العالم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة
الله. إن شاء الله. The young kids that are moving around, please come forward. We're about to begin the program. This is a masjid program, and alhamdulillah, it was put together by members of the masjid program, speakers, community leaders, inshallah, organize it. And something that we need to talk about today in our community, a major issue that we have, which a lot of our youth are facing today. Masjid Tamia, and along with all the other community activists, is obligated to concentrate up and bring solutions to all the community problems that we're facing. So inshallah, while the program is going on, we'll appreciate if all the conversation can be stopped, especially the young kids. The parents, please, would like to request if you bring in a kid with you, any young person, to make sure the person is sitting next to you. This is something that is beneficial. This program, this is only an opening to a big problem that we have. It is an opening to a big problem that we have, and we're not going to come to a solution if we don't take it seriously. We take it lightly, we don't give it a lot of attention. The problem is there, we see the problem. It's just that when it comes to fixing the problem, we don't take it seriously. So inshallah, for the people that are here today, we'd like to request from them to give their utmost attention, because you can be the change yourself. The problem that we're going to address today, inshallah, is going to pertain the drugs and the communication between drugs and mental illness. We have a special guest, inshallah, that will be giving us details and information about how to fix the problem. First, inshallah, we're going to have a chef, Chef Rosette, and our doctor, Dr. Marwan, Sister Mariam, who is representing the health department. And we also have Brother Mohammed, who is be speaking up, Mohammed Al-Samid, who is going to be speaking from the youth aspect. And again, this is just an opening. We have, ever since a long time ago, the beginning of 2010, 11, 13, before that, the issue of drugs was not known in Somali community. But a problem right now, since we neglected and we didn't give attention to it, escalated to the extent right now is getting to each and every single house. And it's burning each and every single house. We have masjid. The masjid concentrate upon fixing the community problem. And the masjid will not going to be able to fix the community problem if the community themselves are not willing to help fix the problem. So together, we're going to talk about this issue. Everybody, it's going to be a discussion too, it's going to be a discussion. And everybody sees this, and this is something that everybody knows. It's not something that is hidden, it's not something that is unaware, it's not something that is private, it's something that each and every single person knows that we're dealing with, we're facing a problem today. So we want everybody to participate, engage, listen, talk, give solution, your opinion, your views, what you know, how can we approach this problem. Anything that you can add on helping to fix this problem, inshallah ta'ala, in this program today, we will inshallah put it together. And this is not the first, and it's not going to be the last. And then after this, inshallah, we're going to take steps on how to fix the problem. Jazakumullahu khairan, barakallahu fikum.
Bismillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah alladhi khalaqa fasawa thumma qaddara fahada. Wa salatu wa salamu ala nabiyyihi al-mustafa Muhammadin wa alihi wa man iqtada bi qudwatihi ila yawmid din amma ba'd. In the interest of time, I will try to keep my portion of this as short as possible. And for a very, very needed and deep conversation regarding some of the things that are happening within our community and have been happening for a very long time. Seemingly a sore that has been left to rot for some time and has not been attended to until it got too bad. And then we started to look at solutions for a problem that has been going on for some time. The issue of substance abuse or the use of intoxicants and its spread through our community, whether it is between the younger people or the older people, is something that we truly, truly need to have a conversation and an uncomfortable conversation at that about. And although when things like this happen, people love to play some kind of blame game. And when we look at kind of the rhetoric surrounding this issue, a lot of people think of it as a strictly youth problem, right? And I know some people, this word youth, they've gotten tired of hearing this word youth because it's been used so many times across the masajid and so many different Muslim communities, but we think of it as a problem that strictly plagues the younger generation without seeing the prior things that cause this issue. And at times we think of the problem of drug abuse as either being one completely and wholly related to one's measure of iman, or looking at it as completely and wholly related to one's mental health, without thinking that the both of these things have a profound effect one upon the other. That at times when one feels a poor mental health and they fall off their ibadah, they can fall into things that can only be led to by a low sense of iman. And that when one feels so low in his iman, shaitan can use this opportunity to misguide them into a situation that is bad for their health. And so the warning of this issue of harming yourself is something that is not shied about in the Quran and in the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, the other thing that we must recognize regarding this specific issue at hand today is that one of the chief reasons in which this happens, without a doubt, is due to a lack of opportunity or a lack of understanding of those said opportunities. What do I mean by this? Shaitan's entire goal is to mislead us and guide us into the fire. That is what Shaytan wants us to do. إِنَّمَا يَدْعُ حِزْبَهُ لِيَكُونُ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. That him and his group call for you to be the people of Sa'ir. Now Shaytan will leverage any and every means necessary to misguide you and take you to the worst place possible. Whether that is facets of the dunya that he uses to misguide you, or facets that are deep and internal within your iman. Among these things is that a person does not have a stable income, does not have a job, does not have a good hobby that keeps him busy, or other things that are outside of his sphere of influence, such as a poor family life, an absentee father, a neglectful mother, a child growing in an environment where drug abuse and substance abuse exists. These are all reasons and ways in which a person can fall into these things. But these things are not a death sentence, and they're not situations that are inescapable and cannot be left, and that there is hope at the end of that tunnel, and there's light, and wherever there's an issue, there is always a solution. So inshallah, with this conversation, we have a man of profound knowledge, especially in the medical field, our Sheikh and Dr. Marwan,
And also another brother of ours who is a sheikh in his own right, who will also be talking to the parents about these issues and their solutions. And so inshallah, I will defer to them, humbly so inshallah.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا ما يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا أما بعد. As the brother have mentioned, substance abuse is one of the things that we tend to see in pretty often when you're in a hospital setting. So I could talk about, you know, some of the things that the families should have done, what the message should have done, what the family should have done. But at the end of the day, you guys don't see what I see when it comes to the hospital. You don't see the kind of sicknesses that we deal with and the complications and the disasters that patients would have to go through when they come to the hospital. Unfortunately, a lot of times people tend to take substance abuse as being fun. It's cool. It's, you know, it's something that it gets you euphoric. You get really high, and it's really interesting. But at the end of the day, you got none of the people who ever initially try any sort of drugs knows the complications that we tend to, you know, that they would run into themselves into once they come to the hospital. When it comes to the relationship between substance abuse and mental health, it's almost like a chicken and an egg, you know. And a lot of times we don't know which one comes first. Sometimes, a lot of times, people who are addicted, they're addicted with many substance abuse, they end up eventually having a lot of mental disorders. When it comes to anxiety, depression, suicide, ADHD, you name it. So sometimes people who have mental health problems, you know, they have depression, anxiety, because of the fact that they are so anxious and there is no set of medication that could control their need. Sometimes they would go into substance abuse for them to fill their thirst. You see, so it's a lot. But the majority of the issues, the majority of the people who are within the substance abuse, usually people start with addiction, and then eventually they would work themselves into mental health issues. 90% of the people who end up going into substance abuse, they start with alcohol and smoking. You know, this is very interesting, because sometimes we talk about the very first thing that comes into our mind when it comes to substance abuse, people think of the illegal things, right? But a lot of times it's the legal things that, and regardless whether it's legal or illegal, from our perspective, it's haram. But when it comes to alcohol, this is one of the things that many people who, yeah, that's why in our deen we call it Umm al-Kaba'ir, you know, the mother of all, you know, sins, or the mother of all great sins. Because of the fact that alcohol, you know, can lead you to other things. Can lead you to hanging around with the wrong crew. Can lead you trying a new set of medication. Can lead you to, you know, being out at night and trying to get even more high. So you see, so that's the kind of problem. Because thing is, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that, you know, he described the road toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a straight door and with many windows, right? And he described the person who opened the door. He said, and Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam exact word was, "فَإِنْ فَتَحَهَا فَقَدْ وَلَجْ." You know, if as soon as you open it, خلاص, because thing is, you open yourself. Don't think, one of the most important aspects, ya ikhwan, and this is something that is mainly for the youth, is that one of the main reasons why people want to try heroin, Percocets, oxycodone, Dilaudid, fentanyl, you name it, ecstasy. The number one reason is why kids want to try this. You know what? What is it? Curiosity. People are just curious. Like, you know what? They say, like, you know what? I know I'm not going to be addicted. I know for fact I'm not going to be addicted. I'm just going to try it once, and then see how why see why these guys are doing it. So a lot of times people are curious, and a lot of times curiosity gets you in trouble, because thing is, don't think. A lot of times when you are curious, at the end of the day, there is one thing that you are doing. You're trusting your nafs. You're trusting your own nafs. And when you do so, what happens? Your nafs is going to take whatever you're going to give her, and it's going to run with it. You see? So the point here is that, and this is maybe something that we need to talk to the parents too. You know, because thing is, a lot of times, we, you know, from when things come to my end, ya ikhwan, when I see things, it's too late. Because I see people who are admitted to the hospital, and they're sick, and they're just overdosed, they're close to death, and then this is when I come to try to fix problems. So, to the parents, what some of the things that can get your kids in trouble? The way I look at it is pretty. I call it the triad of trouble. Okay, the triad of trouble. The three things. You know, when you have a kid who have free in time, free, they have nothing to do, they have money, and they have no supervision. The next thing that is going to come out of this is substance abuse. You have a kid who is, you know, you don't bring them to the masjid. I'm not saying you have to be in the masjid all the time. Yeah, and it make them busy, whether it was, you know, extracurricular activities, you know, doing stuff at school, with sport, games or whatever. You have to keep your kids busy. You have to. And then on top of that, a kid who is free, and then you give them money. You give them money. Because thing is, the kid, you know, money with them is like something that they have to spend. It's not like the adult mentality, I have to save it, I have to put it here, I'm going to invest it. No. Kids, they have money, they're gonna look into how I'm going to spend it. And if they're surrounding and spending using wrong avenues, of course they're gonna invest it in that. So a kid who is free in time and they have a lot of money and they have no supervision, as the brother have mentioned, their father is somewhere, he's at work, he's driving a truck, or he's working 12 hours a day, and he comes at 9 o'clock, and the mother is maybe she's working and she's throwing her children in daycare, and she's coming home. Of course, all of this thing is going to happen. You see? So this is something that you have to think about, because yes, the masjid is there for us to give us guidance. The masjid is there to give us guidance, and the impact of the masjid, no matter how much the masjid is going to do, is going to be limited. And then, yeah, we could have lectures and we could have talks and guidance and blah, blah, blah. But at the end of the day, the majority of the work is going to be at the family level. You know, I always say, having children it doesn't take a whole lot. You know, monkeys have kids, donkeys have kids, you know, animals have kids. It's nothing, but what makes us as a human being is that when you bring kids, you upgrade them. When you bring children, you are man enough, and the mother was old enough, mature enough to become pregnant and bring a child into this earth. But the next thing, what are you going to do with this child? That's the problem, ya ikhwan. It's a responsibility that you have to take care of your children and have the appropriate supervision over them. I can tell you, you know, by the way, 60%, look, 60% of hospital admissions in America, you know why? 60% is because of alcohol related. Now, along with that, you know, add everything else that is kind of, because thing is, when you talk about alcohol, let me just, here I'm talking about, again, legal things, but according to us, it's haram. When someone comes in with alcohol intoxication, so like meaning overdose, And then they would have to go through withdrawal, because if you don't drink for 3 days, what's going to happen? You're going to withdraw, you know. And if you see the guy, the impact of how someone was withdraw, wallahi, it makes you want to vomit. The guy start shaking and sweating and become disoriented, and he start hitting people. He's not aware of his surrounding. And if you drink too much, it's gonna affect your stomach. And you're gonna have something called gastritis. The lining of your stomach is going to be inflamed. You cannot eat anything. And if you do that a little bit more, you're gonna have pancreatitis, in which that you have inflammation of your pancreas, in which that you have trouble eating, and you cannot keep anything down your stomach. And if you drink too much, you're gonna have liver cirrhosis, in which that your liver is failing. And when people continue to do so, what's going to happen? Your liver start gaining water, and you see some of these people who drink a lot, they have big bellies, because they're gaining a lot of water. Their liver is not working. And they would have to come to the hospital every 2 weeks so we could drain them. The extra water in their belly, we have to drain it. You know? And etc. So this is here I'm talking. And then sometimes you would have big heart, you know, because of the fact people who drink too much, sometimes they have big hearts. They call it cardiomyopathy, alcohol cardiomyopathy. So my dear respect brothers and sisters, people don't, here I'm just talking about alcohol, just alcohol and what's its side effects. And along with that, people become addicted. And when they're addicted, you have to give, because when someone is addicted, what are you going to do? Of course, when they come to the hospital, you have to give them more medication to calm them down, right? So now you're exposing to your body, other than the intoxicant that you are taking, now another medication that you have to get used to, whether it was benzodiazepines or whether it was other medication is going to calm your agitation down. So now you're exposing yourself to even more stuff. Few months ago, someone he came into the hospital, and he overdosed, I believe, in heroin, and he injected himself, he was injecting himself in his arm. And what happened is, because he overdid it, and he used to not to clean the needle. What happened is that the needle he used was not clean at all. So what happened is, as he's injecting himself, he injected some bacteria into his bloodstream. So what happened is the bacteria traveled into his hand, through his arm, into his heart, and he had what we called infective bacterial endocarditis, in which there is bacteria inside of his heart. Okay, now. The bacteria did not settle there. Some of the bacteria flies off and goes into his brain, and now he's stroking. He cannot move. So what happened is, when he came in, he was septic, meaning that there was infection through his bloodstream. You know, because he had bacteria in the endocarditis, he have to take not bacteria for 3 days, like, you know. He has to take bacteria for 6 weeks through his IV. 6 weeks. And he has to go to a facility in order for him to do so, with rehab. And you're destroying your life. The majority of them, they suffer other problems too. But I'm going to end with this. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, I'm sure many of you, and inshallah you're not close to doing such things. But I'm sure many of you know people. I'm sure, because Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, if you come to the masjid, I'm sure that you pray, you have some sort of guidance, your parents is bringing you, right? So the question here is that I'm not so much fearful of you. I'm fearing, who do you know? And that's the way you impact. مَنْ رَأَى مُنْكَرًا فيغيره بيده فلم يستطع فبلسانه فلم يستطع فبقلبه وذلك ضعف الإيمان. جزاكم الله خيرا.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وبعد. إن شاء الله تعالى أن أنفرق تذا والدين تيكو كوبا يكو آدي سنتهاي دكتور مروان يو برادر محمد ورسامي تشاوري لأن يرى الله الله وحانا بمركة والدين تيلان بهو مجتمع صوماليات حدان لهي haddaynu kasoo bilaawno 1919 wadamada markan soo galnay hadii xaq laga soo bilaabo marka waxa loo oran kara jiilkii saddexaad baa ku dhalanaya qurbaha qurbaha markan leeyahay waxaan ka wadaa North America, Europe iyo Australia samakan ila marka 10 sano ee u horeeyay dadku waa weyn way garanayaan bulshadeena waxa la tacaalaysay ama masajidda laga lahayn jiray waxyaabaha qabyaalada iyo wixii ku saabsan because aafadii markaa taagneen midaas ahay 10 sano ee ku xigay waxaan la tacaalaynay afkaarta munxarifka dhalinyaro masaajidda lagu hayo arday iskuulka noo aada mujtamac Soomaaliyeed oo dhalinyaradu intay iska baxaan ay ku biiri jireen ururo munxarifiin oo runtii dhiigga dadka muslimiinta banaystay hooyooyinkii marka waxaan arki jirnay iyagoo intay ooynayaan masaajidda imanayo leh hal ay caawiyo oo laamaha amnigu ay daba socdaan dhibkaasaan na haystay mujtamac ahaan afkaarta munxarifka iyo qofku inuu ururadaas dhiigga muslimiinta xalaashada ee isqarxiya uu ku biiro 10 sano hadda u dambeysay aafada ma haysata marka waxa weeyaan siduu brother maxamed warsama uu ka hadlay dr marwaan uu ka hadlay waxa weeyaan waxaan overdose ka ama drugs ka intoxicants iyo ilxaad atheism oo isagu mar kale aan ka hadli doono maanta marka dhibka na haysta mujtamac ahaan muslimiin ahaan waxa weeyaan drugs oo qaybo badan leh iyo ilxaadkan atheismka oo isaga mar kale aan ka hadli doono dhibaato jirta tan maanta aan ka hadlayno marka maxaan uga hadlayna waxaan rabaa marka inaan idhaahdo kow barnaamijkan uu socon doonaa ma aha mid maanta keliya solutionka la keenay waa mid socon doona insha allahu oo masjid Ibn Taymiyyah insha allahu uu hoos garin doono maanta waa hordhac weeye marka waxaan rabaa marka inaan idhaahno kow dhalinyarada keliya ma aha waxaan la hadlayno waxa uu dhibkanu haysto waalidiinta maanta ugu badan say tahay marka loo yidhaah waalidiinta markaan leenahay Australian aragnay waxa ka jira Europe aan aragnay waxa ka jira waxaan aragnay North America waxa ka jira waxay keentay arintaasi marka in ko furriinku uu barto marka saameyntan ka hadlayda impact waayo waxa la isticmaalayo ma aha wax kaasoo uraya ma aha waxa ku dhacdhacayso laakiin waa wax qofka totally burburinaya Qur'aanka markaan eegno marka Ilaahay subxaana wa ta'ala markuu noo sheegay maandooriyaha wuxuu yiri ko hadaa rabtaan inaa horumartaan liibaantaan ka jooga فاجتنبوه لعلكم تفلحون آيات دا قرانا يسان إنما الخمر والميسر إلا آخر الآية إلهي حليه فاجتنبوه لعلكم تفلحون لنبر لبو إلهي وحي نوشيق يا وحويا آيالات وشيدانكو أذيك سدو محو أذيك سدو كو إنو مجتمع إسكدرو لبنحلو إنما يريد الشيطان أن يوقع بينكم العداوة والبغضاء مروا بمركة عرضة مركة دراجس يا فايلنس وإسلا سعودان وإسلا سعودان ميرو wiil baan naga dhintay muxuu u dhintay koox wuxuu ku jiray drug Minnesota adaysa wiil baan naga dhintay annaga meesha fadhina dad badan ee helaan nooga dhintay ama Canada ha noqoto ama Australia ama meel walba marka waa aafaha dana haysta weeyaan arrinta kale meesha jirta waxay tahay runtii maanta waxyaabahan arkayna waxaa ka mid ah markaan la hadalnay masaajidda Europe iyo Australia iyo meelahan dadka luqadda aan ku hadlay fahmay dhibkan haysta waxaa ka mid ah in kiniiniyadan yaryar ayn sheegayn oo dr marwaan hadda magacyada uu sheegay verbal drunk codin magacyo badan bay leeyihiin in ay noqdeen yacni marka laga hadlayo the power of addiction addictionka awoodiisu xitaa mararka qaarkood waalidiintu ay u tegayaan waalid kale oo loo soo qoray iyagoon garanayn waayo addiction kana wada masalan waxaa la oranayaa heblaayo ilmaha lagu qali c section waxaa la yidhaahda kinin kana loo soo qoraya waxaan aragnay marka si guud baan hadda u hadlaynaa waxaan u hadlaynaa mujtamaca Soomaalida qurbaha jooga in la raadsanayo marka dhibka haysta bulshadani ku tusaysaa maxay marka taasoo keentay in qofku uu wixii ka bixi kari waayo waxaan aragnay waalidiin horey dugsiga caruurta u keenaya cararaya maxaa yeelay waxay rabaan inay soo qaataan waxaan aragnay waalid waxaan ka bixi la ilmuhuna ay ogaadeen oo markaa ilmuhu ay masaajidda imaneen ay dhahayeen aabo ama hooyo waxay u baahan tahay caawimaad macnii daatada markaan sheer garayno waxaan ka hadlay waxa weeyaan mujtamaceena Australia Europe iyo xaggan jooga dhibaatooyinkaasaa jira arrinta kalena haysato siduu markii dr marwaan uu ka hadlayay waxa weeyaan wixii wuxuu iska noqday wax hadda dibba aan loo arag maxay la waxa la leeyahay state hebel gobol hebel ya sharciyeeye it was legalized ya la leeyahay marka inagu dad muslimiina markana ilaahay wuxuu ilaa allahu alkhalq wal amr yaani amarka ya makhluuqa ilaahay baa iska leh bin aadam amarka ilaahay kuma qabsan karo sharciyisana kuma qabsan karo marka maadaama la yiri gobol hebel waa la sharciyeeye waxay keentay marka in dhalinyarada markay kaftamayaan sidoo doctorku sheegayey uu dhaho ma aragtay I just feel like doing it in an samayan raba dan yu saasi kulayhin I just feel like doing it in an iska samayan raba wana qaa'ido shaytaniya because waxaan ognahay saamiri nabiyullahi musa alayhi salaam markii uu yiri ummadan maxaa diinta uga lixisay wa kadhalika sawalat li nafsi macnihi I just feel like doing it wa qaa'ido shaytaniya awi marka and haddaan aragno marka saameynta ay ku leedahay dadka fiiri in ka badan boqolkiiba toddobaatan iyo labo maanta xabsiga dadka ku jira dr marwaanna uu sheegay waxa weeyaan drug related crimes maandooriyo isticmaalay waxbuu kufsaday maandooriyo isticmaalay waxbuu dilay maandooriyo isticmaalay xaasku u gacan qaaday maandooriyo iyadaba isticmaashay odaygii bay mindi gelisay waxyaaba dhaca weeye in ka badan boqolkiiba toddobaatan iyo labo xabsiga dadka ku jira waxa u geeyey waxaanan ka hadlayna weyaan in ka badan boqolkiiba toddobaatan iyo shan sidoo dr marwaan sheegayay waxa weeyaan hospital admissionka marka la eego waxa 2015 ilaa hadda la keenay isbitaalka ayaa u badan waxaa u badan dadka maandooriyaha dartii loo keenay waxaa la yidhahdaa boqolkiiba sagaashan waddankan aan joogno boqolkiiba sagaashan fiiri dhalinyarada da-doodu u dhexayso 14 ilaa 17 dibaan u noqdo waxaa la yidhi boqolkiiba sagaashan inka badan waddankan dadka maandooriyaha isticmaala waxay bilaabeen intaynan gaarin 21 marka 21 sano intuunan gaarin buu bilaabay waxaan ka hadlayna marka waa maxay waa caruurteena weeyaan waa caruurteena weeyaan waxaan ku soo gabagabaynayaa waxaan rabnaa interactive session inuu noqdo su-aalo a weydiisa waxaan ku soo gabagabaynayaa barnaamijkan ahmiyaddiisu waa maxay mar walba oo laga hadlo dhib waalidka soomaaliga wuxuu leeyahay it's not me it's not my children it's not our message maya waxa weeyaan wiilkaagu wuxuu saaxiib leeyahay dad waxaa ku dhex jira gabadhaa dhashay waxay saaxiib leedahay dad waxaa ku dhex jira deriskaaga waxay deris leeyihiin dad waxaa ku dhex jira waa arrinna wada haysa insha allahu tacaala marka waxaan rabaa inaan soo koobo barnaamijku socon doonaa baraadarkan kusoo dhaweynaya kadibna su-aalo iyo xaggiina tilmaan inay ka imaado arrintaasna jaabri baa noo samayn doona insha allahu tacaala
bismillahi raxmaan raxiim alxamdulilahi rabbi alcaalamiin wasalaatu wasalaamu calaa nabiyina maxamed wacala alihi wasaxbi ajmaciin maa bacad insha allahu waa soo koobi doonaa maadaama ee salaadii cishaha la taagan yahay waqtigana uu aada noo hayo anig kolley waxaa ku hadli doonaa magaca dhalinyarada jaamacadaha aado ama on behalf of college students ardayda jaamacadaha dhigato gaar ahaan jaamacadaha wadamadan reer galbeedka ku yaalaan so addictionka markii la yiraahdo sheyga addictionka ah wuxuu ku bilaawdaa usually dhalinyarada markay gaaraan high school 9th grade from 9th the minute uu cunugaas ka baxo middle school 8th grade uu ka baxo the moment uu aado high school his life is changed forever the minute he steps his first step into a high school campus his life is changed forever maalintaasaa nolol waxaa u bilaabanaysa nolol nooc kale u bilaabanaysa marka addictionkaas wuxuu ku bilaawdaa only for two reasons number one either for peer pressure waxaa la yiraahdaa wax culays uu ka dareemo dhalinyarada kale ee la da-da ah ee iskuulka ula dhigto taas waxay noqon kartaa biayi shay maybe waxaa laga yaabaa inuu ka smartsan yahay maybe waxaa laga yaabaa in maaragtay uu loner iska yahay taas lagu liidayo so maybe it can come for any reason ay ku imaan kartaa biayi sabab so peer pressure kaas which leads to for them to follow their destruction maxaa lahaa desires inuu qofki ku dhaco shahawaadkii iyo waxyaabihii uu ka baqayey hadday noqoto maaragtay gabdha ama dumar uu dhex galo ama naftiisii shaydaan wax kale u sheegaan ama daroogadii ama mukhaandaraadkii uu ku dhacoba soo markuu ku dhaco taas ayada markuu ku dhaco maxaa ka dhasho marka what's the outcome marka cunuga uu daroogada ku dhaco waxaa bilaabanaysa waalidkii inay madax isla galaan oo cunugii uu noqdo cunug masaajidkii maan jiray hadduu yahay shanta waqti oo masaajidka maybe laba waqti ama saddex waqti usoo gaabiyo salaadii uu bilaabo inuu timihii la baxo. Timahana ardayda markay gaaraan 17-16 markay gaaraan ay bilaabaan inay madax la baxaan. Markaas taas maxay keenaysaa? Mushkiladaas waxay keenaysaa cunugii iyo aabbayaashii inay isfahmi waayaan. Taasna maxay keenaysaa? Siduu Sheekh Xorseed sheegay inay ka bilaabato meeshii mushkilad ah, mushkilad family ay meesha ka dhalato, hooyadii iyo aabihii isqabsadaan. Aabihiina uu leeyahay ninkan tuurka weyn guriga ha liiga saaro, waayo ilmihii inta kale iga xumeenay ama tusaale xun iigu yahay. Hooyadiina ay leedahay si kastuu wiilkaygu xun yahay anigaa dhalay, banaanka looma saari karo. Markii taas meesha maxay kasoo dhalinaysaa? Waxay kasoo dhalinaysaa family issue. Soo markii arintaas ay dhalato, waxyaabaha kale oo ugu badan aan dhalinyarada runtii ku aragno waxaa ka mid ah cunugii inuu noqdo cunug ah ii sheegeen lack of high ambitions, cunug aan himmo sare lahayn oo noloshii masalan markaa weydiisid oo kale oo ku tiraahdid what are you looking forward to in the next 2-3 years, wuxuu ku leeyahay I just wanna make money forever, waxaa rabo lacag rabaa le inaa samaysto si kastay igu imaan karta ha igu imaato soomaahan. So taas maxay ku tusaysaa? Cunugii inuusan lahayn himmo caali ah ama himmo sare inuusan lahayn. Soo markay taas dhalato, waxaa kaloo aragnay guryahaas oo kale arrimahaas oo kale it may lead to family destructions, hooyadii aabihii inay isfuraan oo furniinka waxyaabaha ugu badan oo hadda la arko oo waaqican hadda la joogo dhalinayo waxaa ka mid ah dhalinyartaas oo isfahmila iyo waalidiintoodii oo isfahmila. So tan ugu dambeyso waxaa waaye aan rabo inaan ku soo gabagabeeyo waqtiga oo aada u kooban daraaddiis, failure in education, cunugiina waxbarashadii noco uu waxbarashadii ka caajiso, cunugana marka uu waxbarashada uu ugu horeyso uu ku caajiso, markaas waaye the biggest failure in his time. Leanna cunug markuu waxbarashada ku caajiso, waxyaabihii culayska ahaay oo dhan uu hal mar isku safsaxaya. Waa arkaa dhalinyarada badan jaamacadaha marka aado waa weydiiyaa, waxaa dhahaa jaamacadaha markaan tago kale dhalinyarta la sheekeysanayo 8 horta biayi shag 10 arday oo kale markay meel isla fadhiyaan 8 waxaa ka mid ah horta gabdho, 8 ilmahaas ka mid ah waa gabdho, laba ku faartay labada wiil laba ay u kala baxayaan. Mid waxaa waaye wiil oo asaga iskiis u yimaaday oo u rabo inuu asaga to better his future and he has high ambitions in life and that's qofkaasna waxa waaye markasta uu ku mahadsan yahay right. Wiilka kale ku soo hartay mid waxa waaye guriga aabihiis iyo hooyadiis fari Allah uga soo saareen oo lagu dhaahay bax bax soo baro oo laakiin asaga option la'aan uu ku yimaan, waxa waa wajigiisa ka dareemaysa kaas markaa aragtid wuxuu ku leeyahay niyo waxbarashadan way igu adkaatay, hooyadii aabihiis haysanaa maalin walba waxay leeyihiin jaamacadan degreegan sidaan anigana ma rabi himma uga uma hayo because saaxiibadii suujeeda banaanka basketball ku ciyaarayaan oo shaqeysan lacagtiya loo soo wiil aan saaxiibana sheekaysanaa dhakor wuxuu igu yiraahday niyo neerka quraankaas la dhameeyay, markaas wuxuu igu yiraahday aan shaqo u socdaa oo iska waxaysanahay okay aan ku dhahay shaqo iska shaqeysan ma fiicna marhumaan ku yiri. Markii maalinkii dambe ayuu soo wacay, muddo kadib uu soo wacay, muddadii kadib markuu soo wacay wuxuu dhahay waxbarashada xagee marinaysaa, markaas waxa ku dhahay waxbarashada soo gabagabow rabtaa adiga maxaa ku qabsoo, markaas wuxuu ugu dhahay niyo waxbarashada gabdhaha loogu talagalay maaskaga soo tagtid. So insha Allah taas waxyaabahaas iyo waxyaabo kale oo badan aad jirto ee maaragtay drug abuse-ka ee dhalinyarada ku lid gareeso waxaa ka mid ah inay dambiyo ka galaan waddanka oo ka bacdi xabsiyo iyo waxyaabahaas loo diro. So insha Allah sidii culimadu sheegeen this will be an ongoing discussion, mowduucan hore u sii socon doonaa, isna gana bi wax caawa kaliya ku xadidan insha Allah. Marka taas rabina ku soo gabagabeeyo waqtiga oo kooban daraadiis. Jazakum Allah khair, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Tayyib, insha Allah we'll open up some questions for the audience to go ahead and ask insha Allah to Dr. Marwan or Sheikh Hussein. Do we have any questions regarding the topic that we just recently discussed? Waxaan u furayna hadaltan su'aalo qofkii su'aalka ka qaba topic laga hadlay gacanta tagi kartiina waana weydiin kartiin insha Allah. Okay, so Dr. Marwan, his question is due to the fact that marijuana has been legalized across many states and it's also being said that it has medical properties or it can be used as a medicine, what do we do regarding that that specific drug?
That's a very good question. So, even though, again, just because something is legal doesn't make it halal. So, yes, marijuana, I'm not going to deny the fact. Here I'm talking about from the scientific aspect of it. Okay, I'm not going to deny the fact that there are some properties that the marijuana has that could be good. That you know, science has discovered is good solving certain diseases. Okay, like for instance, I would say, seizures. Okay, seizures. Sarah. There are certain properties of marijuana could help people with seizures. Now the question here is the following: just because the drug have it does not mean you have to smoke it. Like for instance, and that's the problem that I personally disagree with. Just because it have properties within the ushb or within the herb that it has, that does not make it justifiable for you to smoke it. Meaning that there are some pharmaceutical companies that can extract the good properties that could come out of it and make it into pills for you to take, you know? So with that being said, regardless, I would not recommend for you or for anyone else to smoke marijuana because it's a package. Once you smoke it, all the things that comes along with marijuana is going to be affected. The hallucination, the euphoria, the nausea and vomiting, the shrinking of your brain, all that. So yes, I'm not going to deny the fact that there are some good things that could come out of marijuana, but in the same token, this is a properties that pharmacies would have to extract it from the actual herb and then manufacture it into the actual pills. Inshallah, I hope that would answer the question.
وحيري هرتا قلت كواد إن ما دام واحد لقاني جاي مشروع عم ودنا كوا قال يا هاي تاسي ما تسينا سوينه وحاس حلال يا هاي دين تنا هدو حرام فيها هاي وحاس واحد حرام تلامنا وحيري هدي هدو جيد كاسي ولا يا هاي ما دكمل أح أو منفعة ذا إجبتو ما هبونا إن ما دلا صدنا ما جيت كاس صدنا إنه قف كاستعماله especially into cigar han amal inu intushinta oo cadbo saas uma habona waxana u fiican inu raadsado pharmaceutical companies kala to oo sameyn kara maadada manfaada leh kaliye oo laga dhigay kanini amal marka saas oo ga fiican into isticmaal laha ayadoo sidaa any other questions? Yes, what's your question? Why do people drink alcohol? طيب If there's no further questions, I would like to close with an advice to the young people. Originally this was the purpose that I was brought up here, inshallah. So I'll share the advice since this is the end of it, and I'd like to close with this advice. There are two bits of advice that I can share with everyone here regarding drugs and substance abuse and any type of sin that is prevalent within our community. The first of them is to have a good reputation for yourself. If you are a person in the masjid that reads Quran, that wears khamis, that goes to the ma'had, that studies the deen, let that be the image that you show to the world. Let that be the person that people recognize you as. And this goes especially to young people who are in high school or going into college. The reason why is because there's a golden bit of advice that was shared with me when I was younger. And the person who gave me this advice was an instructor that I had in an after school program. He said, work for your reputation so that one day your reputation can work for you. And wallahi, this advice, if a person sticks to it, it can save him from so many dangerous things. Work for your reputation. Be a person that people recognize for khair. Your social media, use it as a place that you post khair. your public outlook and the way that people see you, be a person that is seen for doing khair. I will share something that it had an effect on in my own personal life. And this is not to boast, and wallahi, I hope that my intentions are sincere and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts from me, but this happened to me in my real life. When I was younger, in my high school days, I was a part of a group called Ask a Muslim, which still runs to this day. Ask a Muslim gave me an opportunity, alhamdulillah, that I can never repay, especially Dr. Marwan, for. It is that they allowed me to go outside into the world and give da'wah. From then, people started to recognize me as a young man who was out here giving da'wah to Christians, non-Muslims, so far, so on and so forth. And from that point on, other young people who are around my age also recognized me as this. Now, what came with this was a perception as a quote-unquote religious fella. This guy is holy. These perceptions came with it. And though at the time, as a young person, you may dread these reputations. Oh, these people don't want to say certain things around you. They don't want to bring certain things around you because you're seen as somebody with deen. Wallahi, this is the best thing that could happen for you. Because certain things, they will not want to try near you. Certain things, they will not invite you towards. Certain things they will not want to get a share with you and have around you. And this is Allah protecting you and protecting the space that you occupy. Stay with the deen. Make friends with the people in the masjid. Make friends with good people. Wallahi, the group that will not desert you are the people here today in this masjid. The people that you go to your class with. The people that you're in the ma'had with. These are the people that you should be trying to impress and you should be around. That is the first advice that I want to share with you. The second advice is just as important, but it is the relationship between you and Allah, and especially your salah. Guard your salah. Inna salata tanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar. Salah stops you from all manner of sins in multiple ways. Imagine the one who is thinking in the moment that he's about to do a sin, salah time is here. Even something as simple. This happens to us a lot. Oftentimes we have apps on our phone that have adhan. Imagine you are about to engage in something that Allah is not pleased with and the adhan plays. Where is your heart then? Will you turn it off, ignore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding you of something that is the relationship between you and Him, and go ahead and do the thing that is bad? Or will you then remember, just like Yusuf alayhi salam remembered, وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا لَوْلَا أَنْ رَأَى بُرْهَانَ رَبِّهِ. Had it not been for the fact that he saw the clear evidence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would have done that sin. But Allah saved him as a messenger and at the fact that he was reminded in that moment. Take care of your reputation and take care of your salah. That's my advice to all the young people and even the older people here as well. Jazakumullahu khair. And we want to thank Masjid Ibn Taymiyyah and IT Youth for organizing this, as well as GHED, Jazakumullahu khairan, for your contributions to this conversation. And a special thank you to Dr. Marwan and Sheikh Rusaid. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Bismillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulullah. Waxa la iga codsaday inaan bal wax yar dul maro ama aan ka falceliyo muxaadaradii iyo barnaamijkii hadda noo dhammaaday ee drugiska sida caruurta looga ilaalin lahaa dhalinyarada. Waa barnaamij runtii aad iyo aad muhiim u ah, loona baahan yahay in la sii badiyo. Oo hadda dadkii ka hadlay barnaamijka waxay ka hadleen guud ahaan effectiska ay drugiska ku leeyihiin dhalinyarada iyo, laakiin in hoos loo daadego oo dee dhalinyarada laftooda laga qayb geliyo, kuwa waxaan soo maray sida ay dhalinyaradu waxaan ugu dhacaan, in dhalinyarada laftooda laga qayb geliyo, in xataa dad waaweyn haddii jiraan oo arrimahan ka warqaba laga qayb geliyo, macnaha in hoos loo daadego oo si in detail ah, hal habeen bisa wax ku filan maaha iyo laba maalmood iyo. Marka waxaan kaloo kusoo koobi lahaa laba arrimood ayaa muhiima: relationship caruurta iyo waalidka relationshipkooda iyo relationshipka labada qof oo caruurta dhalay waa qayb weyn iyaduna oo inta badan aan si fiican loo eegin oo maaragtay marka ilmahaaga inaad relation la yeelato oo ilmahaaga aad mar walbaba uu debate idiin socdo oo aadan hadalka ku celin oo wixii uu dhibsanayo iyo waxa uu dareemayo inuusan kaala biqinin kalsoonidaas inaad ku abuurtid oo mar walba conversationkaas uu socdo waa wax aad iyo aad muhiim u ah waxaa kaloo aada muhiim u ah relationshipka labada qof oo caruurta dhalay inuu aada u wanaagsan yahay inaysan wax conflictiya inay labadiinna idinka dhex jiraan caruurtaas aysan dareemin caruurtaas marka waxay noqonayaan dad meel peaceful ku koray kalsooni waalidkii ku qaba laakiin markii labada waalid ay xinifi dhex taalo oo hadal taagtaagan iyo dagaal iyo iscanaad uu jiro ogow caruurtu they get frustrated wax la yidhaahdo way wareeraan markaas taladay u baahnaayeen iyo mashaakilada haysta inay xaliyaan ama dad kala tashadaan meel kaley u raadsadaan waayo ilmuhu markii hooyo iyo aabe midna lama jiri karaan idinmana dhexdhexaadin karaan marka haddii xataa wax jiraan inaysan bannaanka u soo bixin inuu ilmuhu aysan ogaan waa muhiim si aan kalsoonidooda u lumin waxaan inta badan ilmuhu investment bay u baahan yihiin investmentiga maaha lacag base ilmuhu waxay u baahan yihiin waqtigaaga inaad u hurtid waxyaalo badan oo adduunyada maslaxadeeda inaad uga baaqatid inaad ilmahaaga investment gelisid soccer inaad u raacdid oo inta uu banooniga ciyaaraya ilmahaasi aad joogtid meesha oo soccer maam aad noqotid ama soccer dad marka qofkii keligiis ku ahna badanaa waxaa jira maamooyin keligood ciyaalka ku ah laftoodu inay la kaashadaan dadka kaloo ehelkooda xiriirkiina aad wanaajisid ilmahaagu inuu comfortable kugu yahay haddii dhibaato haysato inuu ku weydiiyo dhibaatadaas noocay doontaa ahaato teenage-ka ilmuhu markay yihiin waxyaalo badan marxalado kala duwan bay maraan marka ilmahaas inuu kula tashan karo uusan kaala biqin wuxuu dareemayo marka intaa unbaan ku soo koobi lahaa culummada inoo soo diyaarisay barnaamijka iyo masaajidkuna aad bay u mahadsan yihiin waan u baahannahay barnaamijkan in la sii waasiciyo oo runtii dad badan laga soo qaybgeliyo intaasaan ku soo koobi lahaa
bismi illahi raxmaan raxiim magacayga waxaa la yidhaah maxamed axmed batuun caawa waxaan ka soo qayb galay muxaadarada ka socotay masjidka ibnu taamiya marka hore waxaan u mahadnaqayaa maamulka masjidka iyo dhammaan dadkii soo qabanqaabiyey muxaadaradan runtii muxaadarooyinka noocan oo kale ah waxay u yihiin faa'iido badan community-ga guud ahaan waxaana rajaynayaa inay kan iyo kuwa lamidi ay sii socdaan dad kale waxaan ku guubaabinayaa inay ka soo qayb galaan waxaan rajaynayaa faa'iidooyin fara badan ayaa laga faa'iidaysan karaa oo ay ka mid tahay in ubadka lagu toosiyo waddada saxa ah in laga ilaaliyo waxyaabaha ka leexinaya waddada saxa ah in lagu guubaabiyo tacliinta in mar kasta laga warhayo caruurta iskuulkooda ku xidhnaanshaha masaajidada iyo goobaha lagu caabudo marka insha allah waxaan rajaynayaa inay sii socoto muxaadarooyinkeena iyo kuwa la midiba